Hey, horsey people. I wanted to talk about hooves because I still get a lot of questions about why you hate horseshoes and why you don't think. Look, and if somebody ain't never seen these videos, this is Buddy and Mr. T. Buddy's to the left, Mr. T's to the right. There's a story about them if you want to know about them. But basically, they see something going on over there. See that? We call that a clue. Look at that alert. Look at Buddy. Mr. T's looking. Buddy's looking. What do they see? Is there a coyote run? I'm going to move around here and see what I can see. Oh, they got some cattle moving over here. The neighbor must have let some cattle loose because there's kind of like a bunch of cattle heading this way. That's a good picture of these two. So anyway, I get questions about the hooves and why I'm so anti-shoe, etc. And why don't wild horses need shoes? And why do we... Look, the hoof is a very complex thing. It looks pretty simple. But if you really get into it, you understand all the complexities that go inside that hoof, the hoof wall. There's cushioning, you know, there's different little sacks. There's the sole, there's the white line. I mean, there's just all kind of things in that hoof. So, to me, the worst thing you can do to a hoof is puncture it, open it up, and allow bacteria to get in there with a stinking metal nail that you hammer in. Now, I know all the horseshoe lovers and all the show people who think they have to have new shoes for every show so it looks polished and neat and it's all pretty, and they're not going to get it because they're all about their ribbons and their shows and them. It's not about the horse. But horses don't need shoes. They don't need it in the wild. Now, granted, they aren't carrying weight in the wild. And when you start carrying weight in a saddle and you're doing things that put more pressure on the hooves where a horse is pulling a wagon or working, you're going to wear down the hoof more if you're using it as a working horse every day. So, but it's still, shoes are still bad. Even if you need them and they're justified, they're still bad. They compromise the hoof wall. They put a hole in the hoof. They allow bacteria to go in. The hoof can't grow naturally. It pounds the hoof. It's metal. I always tell people, the people that love shoes and say it doesn't hurt the horse, put a damn metal plate in the bottom of your shoe and then go walk around or go for a jog and see how far you get before your knees, joints, and ankles just hurt because it's transferring that cushion. It's the same way with running a horse on concrete, even if he doesn't have shoes. If you run a horse on concrete, you're going to hurt him. It's not used to running on that hard, solid surface, 1,200 pounds with you on his back, hitting concrete. So when you put shoes on, it's like a horse running on concrete all the time. Well, Rick, in my arena, they have thick, and it's 2 inches, and they grate it, and it's soft sand. I don't care. A horse's, when you put metal and nails on a horse's hoof, it constricts the hoof. It stops the normal flexing. It stops the ability of the hoof to open and close, to move, which all creates blood flow, which all makes a healthy hoof. A shoe stops all that. And if you do your research, it's very easy to find how bad a shoe is to a horse. The people that are defending horseshoes have never took the time to do their own research and say, let me see if a horseshoe really is bad and research how bad a horseshoe is for it's bad. Now, horses don't need them. And I had a question the other day, why don't horses need to be trimmed? I'm gonna beat Buddy's ass. Buddy, I'm filming over here. If you make Mr. T pull, you're gonna get a beating. You better knock it off. You're in big trouble. Mr. T beat your butt if I wasn't here. Learned that shit from his mom. He used to pick on the other horses and his mom would back him up. It's okay, Mr. T. Poor Mr. T, trying to be a good horse. Buddy, you're in big trouble, mister. You're going to get it. So, and the reason why you don't need... horses in the wild don't need shoes is they naturally trim their feet. They travel for food, for water. They're walking. They're running from predators. They're playing. They're chasing mares. The mares are running from bachelor stallions. Stallions are running after other bachelor herds. There's all kind of activity which naturally wears a horse's hoof down and keeps it to where it needs to be. And in the wild, they're not breeding horses for their pretty heads and their pretty tails and their pretty bodies and all the other crap. So horses that are born with bad feet die. They can't keep up with the herd. They can't move enough to find food. They can't get away from predators. They have sore feet. They limp. They look lame. Predators target them. They get picked out of the herd. There's all kind of reasons on why horses in the wild have great feet. Because the ones with bad feet die off. And we, as stupid humans, breed horses. We don't worry about the feet. We breed a bad hoof gene into horses, and we go, well, we need to have horseshoes, and we need to do this, and we need boots, and we need this. We have to help the horse. You help the horse get that bad hoof by breeding and continuing to breed a certain bloodline, so you can get a ribbon and pay $500 to get a 50-cent ribbon in some show for your ego, instead of looking at it from the horse's value, that breeding and overbreeding is bad. It's not natural. The less strong gene does not get weeded out. Instead, we preserve the weak gene and we do all this other mechanical crap to keep it in order to get a pretty horse. So horses do not need shoes in the wild. Their hooves get trimmed from the rocks, and they stand in mud puddles, and they walk in water, so it gets soft, and then they walk on rocks to leave, and then it trims it, and then they run, and they run over rocks. I mean, how many pastures, how many domesticated horses have you seen, any barns, anywhere, that has rocks where horses have to walk over rocks, walk around rocks, and be in rocks? You just don't see it. Because we have bred horses to where they have such soft feet, and we've put shoes in it over generations. When Buddy was born, his mom, his dad, and all the horses before had horseshoes. He's got 3 or 4 siblings, and all of them need, key word here, they need horseshoes, Rick. It's in their bred. They all have bad feet. Buddy ain't never had a damn shoe on his foot, and he does freaking fine. He carries my fat ass around. So I don't want to hear this shit about a horse needs shoes. They do not need shoes. If you give a horse good care, you let the hoof grow naturally, and you let him be exposed to different things, and you don't lock him up in a stall with sawdust that sucks the moisture out of a horse's foot, that makes them dry and chipped, because you don't want to have to clean the stall because it stinks, because it poops, and so I'll throw in all this shaved dust and all this other crap, which totally zaps the horse's hoof, and then you got the idiots that don't put anything in a stall, and then they're standing in urine and feces, and that acidity zaps the horse's healthiness out of the foot. And then you got idiots saying, my horse has bad feet, I need shoes. Because you keep your horse locked up and pissing shit. That's why they need shoes. So, I mean, I just can't get through the thick-headedness of the horse world to say, look, if your horse is kept in a natural environment to where he can roam and play and graze him, well, Rick, I live and I can't. You know what? Then you shouldn't own a damn horse. Horses were never bred, survived, domesticated, so you could lock them up in a freaking cell just so your sweet little selfish person can say, I want to own a horse. Even though the horse has to pay for it every day of his life, it doesn't matter. You want to be selfish and say, I should have the right to own a horse. Well, you do. And the horse has to pay for your selfishness. Okay? I don't like boarding horses. I mean, it took me forever to find a place before I had my own place. And when I was when I just had Mr. T or Buddy, it took me forever to find a place to where they let the horses graze. I refuse to lock these guys up, and I just don't like it. And I think it's wrong, and I think it's cruel, and I think it's selfish. And I know everybody's going to take that personally and say, I'm picking on you, and you're not a selfish person, and you love your horse, and you bring them cookies, and it doesn't matter. A horse is not designed to be locked up. It's not good mentally. It's not good for his feet. It's not good for his muscle growth. He can't stretch. He can't run. He can't buck and kick. He can't play with other horses. He cannot be a normal functioning horse when he's locked up for 8, 10, 12 hours. And most people tell you, well, my horse is only locked up for 8 hours. I've been in 1,000 different barns, and I don't want to hear that shit. Because it's either a holiday, a graduation, Christmas, thanks. There's always 1,000 reasons that a horse is locked up for 2, 3, 4, 5 days at a time. And you got the owner saying, I love my horse. My horse is never locked up for more than 8 hours. If you say that, you're full of shit, because it just ain't true. I've never seen a horse locked up for... Now, if you own your own property and you bring them in at night and you let them loose every morning, then maybe. But I've never seen it. Most people find excuses to not go out there in the cold or in the rain or in the mud and leave them locked up for long periods of time. It's not good for their feet. This video is about feet, but everything's connected. Okay? Training, learning, understanding horses is a process. It's not an event. You have too many people going out there talking about, I'm going to work on the hoof and I'll put shoes on it. I'm going to work on the head. I'll put a tie down. I'm going to work on the horse pulling. I'll put a bigger bit. I'm going to work on the horse, not moving fast enough, so I'll put metal on my heels and I'll spur him. I mean, everyone wants to take horse problems as an event, an isolated event, instead of looking at the whole big picture. It's a process, and everything comes together. And whatever your problem is, it can't be fixed by one event. It's an ongoing problem that you've created through a multitude of events that caused your problem. And then you want to come to me or someone else, or buy a video, or buy a book, or ask somebody at a barn witch and have them give you the one special answer that no one else knows on how to correct this problem that's being created by a multitude of events. So, anyway,
what are you guys looking at? Are they getting close to your fence? Oh my goodness. Buddy needs to get in big, he's gonna get in big trouble because he's been a bad boy and he bit Mr. T. I'm gonna bite.
That's what you do with Mr. T. There ain't no sense in that.
It's okay, Mr. T. He's being mean to you. I know. Say, I'm an old man. I just want to be left alone. I want to be a good horsey.
You're in big trouble. You bite Miss Chi again, you're getting 5-finger discount, boy. Alright, so that's my spiel on hooves. That's why they don't need it in the wild. That's why they don't need it now. It's all about care. It's all about the big picture. Alright, hope that helps. Pulling out there. Buddy, better tell your good boys.